We're grateful because we watched cold cases and it gave us hope.
27 years. That's how long a Metro family waited to see somebody charged with their loved one's murder. Kansas City, Kansas police announced a break in the case today, along with three other unsolved murders. Good evening, and thanks for joining us in Fox 4 News at 10 o'clock. I'm Kevin Barry.
And I'm Shannon Russo. The department's cold case unit has spent nearly 2 years now working on about 300 cold cases, all spanning six decades. Three cases are one step closer to being closed tonight. And for the families involved, it's an immense relief and something they're still trying to process.
Our family is grateful. We're thankful that someone has been charged and arrested.
One step closer to justice, a major relief for Arvetta Davis. She listened as Kansas City, Kansas police announced an arrest in her aunt's murder from 27 years ago. Pearl Davis, also known as Samima Musawir, was found dead inside of a home back in November of 1996. Her accused killer, Gary Dion Davis Sr., who's also accused of killing a second woman, Christina King, on Christmas Day in 1998, another case that was cold until today.
We're still all trying to process it. She has two children, and I need to mention them. Their names are Cordria and Aisha Musawir, and they were very, very young when this happened. So they've been waiting a very long time for someone to be held accountable for what happened to their mother.
Detectives nabbed Davis after DNA from both women's murder scenes matched his DNA profile. He's now charged with two counts of second-degree murder. Detectives say he worked as a truck driver at the time of both murders and believe he may be linked to even more victims.
In my experience, based on him killing two women, most likely he's killed more.
The third cold case with a major break is that of 16-year-old Dion Estelle. He was found shot to death and lying in a creek bed in the summer of 1997. Detectives say his accused killer, Leon Caldwell, is already in prison in Lansing, Kansas for killing a different man in Wyandotte County. He's currently on hospice and, detectives say, wanted to confess before he dies. Since the investigations are still considered ongoing, police would not reveal any other details, including if the victims knew their killers.
So we're just grateful that he's at least been charged.
And the final victim discussed at today's news conference is only known as baby girl Jane Doe. She was found inside of a dumpster in 1976, just hours after she was born. Investigators determined her grandmother killed her. Since she's died in the years after that, that case is now closed.